Hello and welcome to Pigeon Duiwe News. My name is Tato Schone and today we are at the lofts of Flip, Dieplaagte, Stefan Ding and Silver Star. And in a few moments we'll get to know about their best breeds. The breeds that they've been performing for them in the one loft races for the past 2-3 years. And how did they come together as these three lofts to form this syndicate that's performing so well for them. Stay tuned. Flip, welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it. Welcome here. I hope you're going to enjoy it. And let's see.
And just to start at the beginning, how did you start with pigeon racing?
Yeah, we started, we bought our first pigeons in 2018. Gabby van der Beelen Hen out of the Bliksem line and Philip Norman Kok out of the Zorro line. That's the first pigeons we bought and they performed superbly for us. Till today, some of our best birds. Me and my partner from Sterkfontein, Ruan Mankies, bought a lot of pigeons all over the show. We were very blessed to meet some top fanciers and people that helped us so much. You know, it's always nice if there's people helping you and you're buying the good genetics. As a farmer for 25 years, I've been breeding animals my whole life. I don't know if there's any difference between breeding cattle, game or pigeons. It's the basics stays the same. You need not good genetics, you need superb genetics, super genetics. That's what I think you need to stay ahead and to stay in front. And we bought some pigeons from out of Africa Lofts, a very good friend of mine, Egbert O'Kelly. We've got a cock here, 08350. He is a superb pigeon. He already bred us 13 babies in the top 10 in one-day lofts, in hotspots and in finals and in ace pigeons. So it's a superb. Then also, Gigi Gadden from Sudwaring Loft helped us a lot. And even Thomas Smith, we bought some very good pigeons through him at Sudwaring. And he also helped us with some of the pairing to pair it up. And it worked like a bomb to us. We're very blessed, you know. We are humbled by what we have achieved, but we give the Lord Jesus Christ all the glory for that, and that is our main mission at this loft. You know?
Speaking of Egbert and the other fanciers, were they your mentors throughout?
Well, they helped us, but us being in the animal breeding arena with the farming, we could do it on our own, but to get that top genetics, they definitely helped us a lot, yeah. Uncle Gigi and especially Egbert O'Kelly from out of Africa Lofts for sure.
What super bloodlines that you have in this loft that kept you in front in all of these one loft races?
The crosses that we made worked out superbly at the out of Africa lines that we crossed with the Gigi lines. The mixed lines with the Carellis worked superbly for us. And they're flying in front all the time. And then we also brought in the pigeons from Oom Dirk from Silver Star Lofts. Dirk is our third partner. He flies with us in the summer races. He is a superb fancier. He's been a fancier for a long time. He does so well. I personally think he's got some of the best genetics in the country. We brought in the flash line that you're part of, the family, because you guys bought flash on the auction, and you know what superb genetics that is. 2113 that's in the loft that scored last year or this year at Carnival Summer for us. He was the only bird scoring twice in the top 10, finishing eighth in the final, fifth ace bird. That is that genetic line that we've got. It's superb, and that is what you must keep trying to breed by line breeding and by inbreeding. That is absolute a necessity.
Dieplaagte, Sterkfontein, Silver Star Lofts were very blessed in the last 3 years at One Day Lofts. Every year in these 3 years, we had a pigeon in the top 10 on the final. We've got a couple of pigeons that we bought back. 2113, she flew very well in 2021. Then we also got a DPL free. That is a super hen. That is my favorite hen. She came second on the final at Bloemfontein last year, but she's an equal winner. There were only 5 birds back on the day. We bought her back on auction. Then we also bought a pigeon 778. He was the 20th ace pigeon. We were so blessed. And like I said, every single time for 3 years, we had a pigeon in the top 10 on a final. This is 2113. This little hen we bought back at Carnival 2021 summer race. She flew 3 times top 10 on hotspots. She was 8th final, only 6 birds back on the day. She was also the 5th ace bird. We bought her back. She's a niece to Silver Flash that Samuel Lofts bought. An exceptional bird. Constantly in extreme weather conditions, she flew exceptionally well week after week after week. This is a super bird. Like I said, a niece of Flash. This one was bred by Dirk out of the Aridextra lines and the same lines as Flash. This is the father of DPL 3. It's caught 7th in a hotspot at Diaz on 440 kilometers, and it was the 37th ace bird at Diaz. We bought it on auction. A very nice bird. This is the Black Oswalds, the best of the Black Oswalds. He's also the father of DPL 3. This is 778. We also bought this pigeon back last year on Bloemfontein. He was the 20th ace pigeon at Bloemfontein. Out of over 1,000 birds, young birds, and I think with the old birds, it was about 1,800 birds. This is 778, 20th ace pigeon. He also contributed to us being the team champions every single week under the top 50, except for one hotspot. Otherwise, all the hotspots in the top 50. 778. This is a bigger bird. Normally, we like the smaller to medium birds. Actually, the very small birds. That's what we like for one day lofts. But this is a bigger bird, but he flew superb for us. He comes out of a Billy Kitchen brand cock that we bought. This is my pride and joy. This is our number one stock hen, 6777. She's from Sudoring Loft. We bought her from Sudoring Loft. This hen bred 11 birds in the top 10 at one day lofts in the hotspots and in the final. She's also the mother of DPL 3 that were second at Bloemfontein on the final, like I explained a while ago. An equal win. In total, this bird's babies must have won us about 150,000 rand. And I think over the 3 years that we've been participating in one day lofts, our winnings is about 250,000 rand at the moment. You know, sometimes God gives you something that you can't believe. And I think this is one of the birds that we were very blessed with. This is a genuine blessing from God, and we give him all the glory for a bird like this. This is a baby that we bred for stock, DPL 15. It's a daughter, I think it's a hen, out of 6777. She bred us 11 birds, top 10 in hotspots and finals in 3 years' time. She was paired up with a cock 08350 that we bought from Egbert O'Kelly from out of Africa. He bred us 13 birds in the top 10 in 3 years' time. We're gonna keep this bird for stock. This is like a piece of gold. Like I said, 6777 is our number one hen. We're very proud, and we are very humbled by the Lord giving us pigeons like this. It is genuine humbling for us. I thank you.
What are the biggest achievements you got from all of these?
Well, the best achievements we had was Flash, winning with 1 hour, 43 minutes. And there were only, I think, 5 pigeons back on the day, or 3 pigeons back on the day. Then the same happened at Bloemfontein now. We scored second on the final with DPL 3. That is a clear, she just comes out of the Sudurang genetics, out of the mixed genetics, and that pay was actually paid by Thomas Smith for us. Or he said, let's put that together, and it worked like a bomb. You know, that pigeon scored so consistently, and she helped us winning the team competition. That's one of our best achievements that we had, was winning the team competition in Bloemfontein against some superb top fanciers. And that's the kind of genetics I'm talking about that you must get there. You know, and speaking about DPL3, she scored the second in the final, but she's an equal winner. And also in that same loft, we scored third and sixth in the car race from Mikey's Fontein. We were the only loft that could have, that had two pigeons in the top 10 in the car race. So, like I say again, you know, the Lord's hand is absolutely on this loft, and He's blessing us tremendously. But you must do the work. You must breed them right, and you must have, again, that super, super genetics. I'm not a fancier that can hold a pigeon in my hand and tell you this is a good pigeon or this is a bad pigeon. I look at the genetics, I pay them. If they work in the basket at one day lofts, I buy them back, I line breed them, and I inbreed them, and that's how I build my lines.
And building those lines like that, I mean, at the end of the season, 2021, what would you be satisfied most to achieve?
Well, the best achievement that we can achieve if we win the team competition again at Bloemfontein, or finish in the top three. Because I think by winning or doing good in the team competition, you know you have to score every single week in the top 100 or in the top 10% of the loft. And what I love about Bloemfontein Central Provincial Loft is there's over 2,000 pigeons there. So there's a lot of pigeons. If you can do that, you're doing well. You know your lines are right. You know you're doing the things right. So that will be the best achievement possible for us.
And you've been performing well in the one lofts. Why do you perhaps send more birds at the one lofts as to club race, local club race?
Yeah, we don't do club racing at all. We only do one day lofts. I haven't got the knowledge to fly pigeons from home or from the loft itself. But I'm a breeder. Even in my farming industry, I'm also a breeder, and that's my passion, is to breed. And I think by flying in one day lofts, you're on the same level as the top fanciers in the country, because all the pigeons go to one place and they get all the same treatment, and that puts us on a level field with the top fanciers. And that's why I say again, it comes down to genetics, you know. Dirk, our partner in the summer races, told me one thing. A pigeon needs a natural immune system for a one-day loft. And that is the truth. And I think most of our pigeons, that is already bred into them. And that is very important. That's why Dirk is such a crucial part of our team. He knows genetics, he knows how that works. He's been in the game for a long time, so we were very blessed for him to come and join us. Genetics, according to me.
In this whole pigeon sport, I mean, who do you look up to the most? You know, someone you learn from a distance?
Well, I think Egbert O'Kelly and Thomas Smith, those two guys really helped us.
And why so? Why?
Well, Egbert, you know, we didn't only buy pigeons from him. He gave us pigeons that is top performing. That's a man with a golden heart, you know. The same with Thomas Smith, that is doing all Sudurang's loft sales and promotions and stuff, you know. He helped us such a lot. Like I said, he paid up DPL3, the parents to DPL3, that scored second Bloemfontein, and did extremely well there for us. So those are the two people that had very, very big influence on our loft, that's for sure.
And talking about people bringing influence, now I'm going to bring it to your family. Does your family also bring influence to
your race? Oh, yes. My son is also very keen on the pigeons. My wife also, she backs us 100%. And it's good, it's a family sport, you know. We can't wait on race day to check the computer, or somebody will be in front of the computer to see what we do. So it's absolutely, we are blessed, and the whole family is into into the pigeons, that's for sure. But we all love animals. That's been our whole life. We love animals, that's for sure.
This year, and we've been through, you know, this COVID, and how did it impact Dieplaagte lofts?
Well, it didn't impact us that much because we already had a stock. I was a bit worried in the beginning when Bloemfontein couldn't fly, and that was a worry, but we started, and what a season we had. Like I told you, we were so blessed, and the Lord's hand is absolutely on this loft. We've been blessed tremendously. I think if you look at how many years we've been in the game, it's actually a little miracle that we could have achieved what we achieved. In 3 years' time, we had 7 pigeons scoring in the top 10 places in all hotspots, or in the finals at one-day lofts, or in the car races. And it's all different lines. The Sudoring line crossed with the Air of Africa line. The Gabby van der Beelen bring in, we brought that in. The Philip Norman cock that we brought in. We also bought a Hans Goben cock from Carnival, a German cock that was the ace pigeon at Carnival. And that was also one of the best buys that we ever did. And those pigeons are already producing to us. What I've seen and what we are trying to do is ace birds breed ace birds, especially at one-day lofts. You'll see all the pigeons that did well for us, did well in the final as well in the ace competition. And that's the birds we try to buy back, or to buy if it's not our birds. Breed with that birds, best genetics, buy the best genetics, put them in the basket, fly them. If they work, buy back the babies, line breed and inbreed them.
How's the sport impacting you in financially?
No, for sure, there's a big financial, we're all under stress, you know, and there is a definite influence from COVID on the sport. We try to keep less pigeons. As you can see, we don't keep a lot of stock birds. The other birds that we've got here is feeder pairs. What we also do is we don't put 2 babies in a nest pan. There's only 1 baby in a nest pan that goes to the one-day loft, so that they can grow up very strong and get all the nutrition and from the parents. That is one of the things that we do. So yeah, definitely the COVID had an influence on everybody by keeping less birds and quality birds. That is the main thing. And also giving back to the community. I've got a guy in Kagiso, Bongane. He's close to my heart. He flies in Krugersdorp. I'm trying to help him. And with the grace of God, I think he's going to be a super one-day loft flyer in the next few years. So I believe in that. I believe in giving back. The same as what Egbert and Thomas did for us when we started. And even Dirk, you know. Dirk is such a good fancier. But he flies under the radar. He doesn't want the limelight on him. And it's actually a pity, because, you know, if you've got a diamond in your pocket and you walk past 10 guys and nobody knows about it, they will not buy it from you. So you need to expose yourself a bit, but Dirk doesn't mind that. He's a guy, like I told you, who's got such a big knowledge about pigeon racing and genetics especially. And, well, it was like dynamite when he came to our loft and we were partnered up, you know. Like I said, the main thing is to breed in that natural immune system. That is the most crucial thing, I think, at a one-day loft, is for that pigeon to stay healthy. If he's healthy through the season, you will score if the genetics is right.
What's the biggest error that you might have done?
Well, like I said, we didn't do much wrong, but there was times that we did wrong, bought from some people that wasn't the top genetics. But as soon as we start buying the top genetics and getting that genetics and breeding them together, we started producing the results. So I'll say the best mistake we made is buying here and there and that. Buy from a fancier, buy out of a winning family. And like I said to you, ace pigeons breed ace pigeons. If you get ace pigeons from one-day lofts, you got a 50% chance already if you breed with those pigeons to do good. In the farming industry, in the game industry, genetics, like I said, a lot of people tell you, get good genetics, Good genetics doesn't help. You must get excellent genetics, the best you can afford.
And do you have any an ultimate tip that you can give people out there?
Yes, the tip is, I always say, put your trust in Jesus Christ. That's our motto, flying for Jesus, farming for Jesus. And if you do that and you're willing to work hard and get the right genetics, success will come. God will bless you for sure.
And do you have closing remarks?
Yeah, I want to thank you guys for coming today. It's a privilege for me to have you guys here. You know, like I said, you're part of the family. I'm very proud of that you guys bought Flash. It says a lot to me. I don't know a lot of pigeon fanciers, but I know Samuel Lofts because you are an icon in the industry, and it was absolutely a blessing and such a privilege for us that you bought Flash, and I hope that she will do exceptionally well for you guys. Thank you, Tati.
Thanks a lot, Flip, for joining us on today's show. And there you have it from Flip Dieplaagte from the Dieplaagte Lots. And I hope you've learned a lot about genetics, getting the best genetics, like he said. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our TV channel. You can also send us information if you want us to advertise your brand. So you can send to the email below. My name is Tato Skone, and this is Pigeon Duiwe News.